It's a great question. I believe, as many people do and as the mind sciences teach, that we need ways of simplifying our world. They absolutely have to have them because of the fact that an unsimplified world is simply unmanageable. We can't understand it. Understanding that we need to simplify is a key sort of starting point for recognizing the ways in which our ideologies might get in the way of actual understanding, of clarity in our perspective. My research and the research of others suggests that ideology in a way reflects a set of reasons that lead us to policy conclusions or policy preferences. So if I like markets or if I like regulations, I think it's my ideology or a set of reasons and attitudes that form my ideology that are the cause of that preference for markets or regulation. What the mind sciences are suggesting is that the reasons we give rarely are very good predictors or explainers of what's really moving us. And the research that I'm doing now with a co-author, Mark Yeboah, is finding that behind our ideologies often is an attributional style, that we tend to look at a world or look at a situation and make an attribution to see choice or to not see choice, and to think that that's a neutral, unfiltered, objective assessment of fact. However, that's happening more or less because of subconscious reasons. And the way it happens also connects us with an ideology. So where we see inequalities, for example, conservatives, Republicans tend to be more comfortable with that inequality and to make attributions of disposition to explain it. These people are higher because they deserve to be. These people are lower because they deserve to be. It's their disposition. It's their choice. Liberals a little bit less so. So behind these ideologies are attributional styles, and these attributions that we make vary and flip without our being conscious of it. So what's behind those attributional sort of starting points? Well, that's something the mind scientists are working with. There's a lot of possible stories, but one of the more interesting possibilities is that if you ask people across across ideological spectra how they feel about chaos or how much they like clarity and closure, you'll discover that there's a range, and the people who really like clarity and really like closure and answers that are clear to questions tend to be, when you ask them about their ideology, more conservative. And those who are more comfortable with uncertainty, less seemingly motivated to create closure, open to new experience and so forth, tend to be, when you put them on an ideological spectrum, more liberal. The operating hypothesis is that our craving for closure, how much we feel it, may play a causal role in determining our ideologies, which then leads to policy preferences. We might think that it's our reasons that lead to our policy preferences. We wouldn't think it's our craving for closure, for example. And similarly, the desire, sort of people's reactions to salient inequalities is also an amazingly strong predictor of what their ideology is going to be. And how eager they are to explain away inequalities as acceptable or not is also a strong predictor. And again, this is a place where the working hypothesis is that this is causal, that people's craving to explain away inequality is a motive that exists to greater or lesser degree in people. And to the extent it's very strong, people tend to be more dispositionist, and in turn, they tend to prefer conservative policies, and they tend to like markets. And if you ask someone why they like markets, they would not tell you, it's because I'm comfortable with inequality and because I crave closure. But the evidence is suggesting, though it's really early to get, you don't want to go too far with this, but the evidence is suggesting that that is indeed the causal story, that it starts way back at these motives. And where those start is also a subject of study that people are engaged with, but I'll stop there for now.